Hi everyone, my name is Gus Posey. I'm the steam lead here at Wings Over the Rockies Air and Space Museum. Today I'm going to show you a fun paper airplane design called the Sparrow. It's a little bit more complex, and as we're going through the steps, you may find a couple new tips and tricks for your paper airplane folding. But if you stay with me, I think you'll find this is a plane worth folding and definitely worth flying. I'm going to be using a typical 8.5x11 sheet, as I so often do, and in this case, just for a little decoration, I'm going to put the Wings logo right down here at the bottom right corner, face down towards me. Now, to begin this process, I want to make sure that I have some kind of folding tool here. I'm going to use my cylinder-shaped marker. That seems to work pretty well. And, of course, you can use your thumbnail, maybe scissors, anything like that will work just fine. Now, to begin, I'm going to grab the top corner of the page here and just fold that over to the edge. I'm trying to match the edge of the paper so it's a nice, sharp triangle. I don't want it to be big and open and loopy at the top. I want a nice, sharp point on that triangle so that when I fold it, it's right against the edge and comes to a nice, sharp point. Now at the same time, I'm going to open this up, come up the crease to the other corner, and do the exact same thing. So this corner folds over here, once again, just to the edge of the crease, matching the edge of the paper, folding that to a nice sharp point. As you're folding through this, there will be a lot of moments when we just want to get it as close as possible. Perfection, of course, is elusive, but we want to get these lines as symmetrical and as closely folded as we can get them. Now, once I've got those both folded, you can see hopefully on my sheet, I've got a nice X right down the middle of the page here, dividing that into four sections. To make it a little easier, I'm gonna fold it one more time from the top, right here on this middle line, so that the top edge folds down right where the bottom of the crease ends. The reason I'm doing that, that's going to add a crease right in the center of the X, which is going to make the next fold just a little bit easier. Now, once I've got a shape like this, with this folded or pressed against the table here, I want to fold these edges in this way. Now, pressing this down on the table will help a lot, but what I'm really doing is just bringing these two lines together in the middle. And hopefully you can see here, as they start to fold together, I get this kind of weird bulbous triangle shape at the top. But as I start to compress downwards, matching the corners here and matching the corner over here, it's a little bit more recognizable. And as I flatten from the back towards the front, I get a nice sharp point on top of that triangle as well. Then I can take a moment just to adjust, just to make sure that everything's lined up and everything's symmetrical. Coming out here to the edge of the triangle, I'm gonna grab this corner, fold it from the side up here to the top, and I'm just matching it to the triangle underneath. This is important to make sure everything's nice and flat, which is a good rule for that marker. Just as the paper starts to stack up, it does get quite thick. I'll do that on one side, and of course, I'll do that on the other side as well. This gives me kind of a diamond shape, just these two triangles next to each other. Something just like that. Now, just as I folded from the side up to the top, I'm going to fold from the top straight down to the bottom. Once again, I'm just matching that triangle here and matching the triangle on the other side. Another good opportunity for my marker here, just to get a nice sharp crease on them, on those triangles just like that, just to make sure they're not going anywhere. Now this brings us to the tricky step, as we sometimes find ourselves. And what I want you to think about is making this a little bit easier just by orienting the paper. I'm going to turn mine this way, so I've got the long edge towards me, the point at the top. Again, kind of a house shape that I can recognize. And the reason this is a little tricky is because we're going to do the same fold twice, once in one direction, and then the same exact fold in the opposite direction. So just so we're talking about the same shapes, if you can orient your paper this way, that might make that a little bit more clear. Now, specifically, what I'll do is come up to the top of the diamond here and grab this top edge and the corner and just fold that in towards the center here, right onto the center line of the plane. And as I said, the paper is getting quite thick, so using that marker to get yourself a nice sharp crease can be really beneficial. Did that on this side, so of course I'll do that on this side as well. Just a nice long right triangle going right to the top. And hopefully you can see I've just folded those so they're pointing at the top of the house, up toward the point of that triangle. Now here's the tricky part. As I come back here, I'm going to unfold the triangles I just made, keeping the paper underneath folded pretty flat. And now I need to do the same shape in the opposite direction. So coming down here to this edge and the edge of the diamond here, I'll grab that, roll it over, just like before, to the center line, get that nice and flat, and of course, same thing on the other side. This is a good time to just give them both a little pressure to make sure they're nice and compressed and have a nice creased edge. Now, if you've done that, you may notice that we started with the triangles pointing up. Now the triangles are pointing down. We've done both sets. And when I unfold this, keeping these papers down, I have two X's. I'm gonna mark those just so we can see those a little bit better. But I have an X here, and I have an X here, just within my creases, just like this. Now, when I said before that you had reached the tricky stop, that was kind of a warm up for this actual tricky step. What I'd like you to do is try to get your fingers and thumbs kind of like this, kind of a weird camera gesture. And what we're gonna do is line up our index fingers with the top of the X. So just following the crease right up here to the top of the diamond where the lines meet the edge, that's where my index fingers go. Now my thumbs just slide right down this side of the diamond to the bottom of the X where the lines meet the page, or the edge of the page right here. Now here's what that's gonna look like. I'm going to start with my index fingers. That will bring these two lines together onto the table. And that leaves my thumbs free to slide down these edges to these corners and push them forward, making two new triangles that fit right on top of the other triangles that we've just made. Once again, good opportunity for some flattening on those just to make sure they're nice and compressed. Should give you a shape kind of like this. Now, if you have all this, you can take a moment just to make sure it looks pretty good, everything's nice and flat, and then we can continue folding. One note is when we're done folding, this part right here is going to be the beak of our bird. So you can think about that in terms of how pointy you want to make those triangles, really as an aesthetic decision for how you want your bird to look. Now for our next step, we're going to grab this triangle at the top and we're going to fold this straight back away from our new triangles. And you can see on this side, I'm just going to fold it all the way down, as far as it will go before the paper would rip or tear, obviously. But I'm folding it just as we have it on the other side. You can see here, the edge of these folded sections reach right down to the bottom of the page. Just like on this side, I'm going just the same distance all the way down to the edge of those folds. Now at this point, we have to do a little bit of surgery on our paper to remove a piece, but it's a piece that we're going to use. So it's not something we want to discard or throw away. And it's also something that we want to fold or tear as straight as possible. If you have some scissors, you can definitely use those, but I'd like to show you an additional technique for getting that piece off as a nice straight line. If I come up here to the edge of the paper right over here, I'm gonna grab this whole section and fold it from the edge of the paper to the edge of my pocket right here. As you can see on the top, there's no pocket, but on the bottom, I've got some space here that we can call a pocket that I'm gonna use as a reference. So this edge folds to the pocket, and I'm just going right against that other edge. Of course, I wanna make that nice and flat. And what I'm gonna do is make sure that this edge where I'm folding is a little bit weaker so I can tear it easily and tear it in a nice straight line. So what I'll do is fold it very flat and then opposite direction on the same line. I'm going to fold it once more using my thumbnail to really crease that down. And I'm going to do this a total of 5 times. So that's 2. Here comes number 3, nice and flat. Number 4, one more reverse on that. You can already feel the paper getting a little bit floppy there, ready to tear. And one more time, number 5, just like that. Now when I do that, my paper has separated, the fibers are spread out a little bit and I can feel this edge is already quite a bit floppier. So I just make a small tear there, back on the table, and then 4 fingers right next to the tear, just gently spreading down the line. This is a nice technique for separating those papers, but also gives us a nice straight edge that matches exactly. That's gonna help us a lot. Remember, this is a piece that we need, so don't throw that away. We're just gonna put that to one side for just a minute. Now, as we finish this part, we'll get this all set. We'll make another part here and then combine them to finish. On this edge, you can see my top and once again, pocket on the bottom. I'm going to fold this in half with the top on the inside. So just bringing the wings together, matching the corners, getting the bottom nice and flat, just as we so often do. And just folding that and you can start to see a little bit of that bird shape starting to emerge. Now an important step here is we have to fold the wings, and just as you saw with our boomerang plane, you might remember that we talked a little bit about angle of attack and how we can use that to deflect air downwards, send the plane upwards. If you use that line and deflect that air specifically, we can build that into the plane as an angle of incidence. Now what that looks like here is if I fold the wing, I'm going to start folding right where the vertical line meets the diagonal line, and I'm folding it just straight down, just like this. But here's a little trick for you. I'm gonna scoot the wing towards the nose just a little bit, only about 1 degree. I'm just scooting with my thumb just a tiny bit, and I hope you can see this on your screen, but there's just a little bit of paper sticking out right back here. Just a small corner at the edge, just to know that I've scooted my wing forward just enough for that to stick out. And if you raise this up, you can see this line right here, again, a little bigger in front, a little smaller in back. That's our angle of incidence. That's going to deflect some air downwards to help our glider stay in the air. So one wing is folded. As per usual, I'll put the folded wing down and fold the other wing across to match. Like so many of our planes, we do want to add some winglets. That'll give us an additional stability feature, but also another way to control the plane during our flights. So right out here at the wingtip, I'm going to grab a little section, fold it back towards the body, about a centimeter, about as thick as a pencil. And once again, I'm doing that with the wings together so I can fold one, mark where that is, flip it over, and fold this one to match. That's going to give me a nice matched set of winglets, and that's going to help the performance quite a bit. As I have those folded, I'm going to raise the wing up, bring the winglets up and out, and that's going to complete the first section of our plane. I'm just going to set that aside here for just a moment, and then grab my other strip so I can make my other part. Now, a little bit of a tricky fold here. It's the world-famous hot dog bun fold, but it's this long strip. So starting in the middle and just working your way out to the corners is a great way to handle that. Let me see if I can get that folded here nice and symmetrically. And just coming across, we just want to make sure that that's folded as evenly as possible. Once again, it doesn't have to be perfect, but as close as we can get that to a symmetrical flat fold all the way down the length. Now, one of my favorite things about this design is there's something kind of elegant built into it. There's a measurement that we need for the tail here, but it's built into the design. On the bottom of the plane, right from the edge of the wing to the edge of the pocket, it's about 3 centimeters. But that's also the exact dimension of where I'm going to mark my tail. So if I scoot it from the edge of the wing to the edge of the pocket and pinch right where it meets the wing, that's where I know that's where it's going to separate. That's the line that I need. It's built right into the wing. Now, just as check, I'm going to be tearing or cutting from the open edge of this paper. So when it's folded together on my mark, I'm just going to tear, but only halfway. It's real important that you don't tear this off or cut this off. I'm just tearing halfway so that I can fold this edge down to the bottom, just like that. And then, of course, on this side, same exact thing, all the way down to the bottom, just like that. I'm going to take a moment just to pop these back up to kind of a T-shape, just to give us a little bit of a traditional horizontal stabilizer that, again, we can adjust for whatever kind of flights we want to try. Now, if you have this piece folded and you have this piece folded, I'm just going to use this to kind of open my my folded page here with my thumb, my folded page here with my other thumb, and this is just going to slide down here under the triangles, all the way to the front. I'm going to try to get as close as I can to the beginning of the airplane right up here so I know it's right up in the nose, give it a nice strong crease on the bottom, but it should hold by the tail, shouldn't pop loose. Now, I know that was a lot of folding, but if you're at this stage, you have completed the Sparrow, and this is an exciting plane to fly. And once we get on the hangar, I'll give you a few tips on how to test fly that. Okay, if you folded your Sparrow, and hopefully you have a space in which to fly it, it's time for some test flights. And I just want to give you a few tips and tricks on how to fly that that might benefit in terms of height and performance. You might notice just on the airplane itself, I've got 4 big surfaces I can use to adjust that flight. I've got 2 vertical surfaces at the wingtips and 2 horizontal surfaces at the end of the tail. All of those can be adjusted and combined with other combinations of folds and twists just to give you all kinds of different flights. You might notice, for example, here I'm putting it quite close to the wing. I might put this one farther away from the wing. Maybe back here I can put one of these straight up and one of them pointing downwards. All those combinations will yield different results, so I really encourage you to try different combinations when you're experimenting with the Sparrow. The main thing you also want to consider is that sometimes you want a little bit of that anhedral. The wings are pointing down just a little bit, and when you throw it, aim up and give it a lot of power to force those wings back up and then let it glide back down from a high height. Thanks for watching, and join us next time for more tutorials.